today's topic is bond angle. Bond angle is the name suggest. It is the angle between bond pairs. For example, if central atom is attached to two bond pairs, like shape is linear, so angle between two bond pairs, it is 180. If we have three bond pairs, teen bond pair apne paas, then bond angle is 120 degree. And these are planar molecules. Linear, trigonal, planar. They both are planar. Planar, planar means which can be placed on a 2D like board. But in case of tetrahedral, all angles are at 109 degree 28 minute. This is non-planar molecule. First effect on the bond angle is the shape and hybridization. This is sp hybridized, this one is sp2 hybridized, and this one is sp3 hybridized. In sp3, percentage of s character is 1 divided by total percentage of s character in sp3 is 25%. In sp2, percentage of s character is 1/3, that is 33.3%. And what about sp? Percentage of s character is 1/2 × 100, means 50%. Bond angle is directly proportional to percentage of s character and also the shape of the molecule sides. The bond angle, central atom having lone pair is same with different surrounding atoms like NH3, NF3. Now both have one lone pair, three bond pairs, one lone pair, three bond. So when this is the case, we consider electronegativity. You know, fluorine is more electronegative, so fluorine withdraw electrons from nitrogen, so bond pairs are away from nitrogen. So bond pair nitrogen se dur chale jayenge, to bond pair aur bond pair ke beech ki jo repulsion hai, because distance badh gayi to repulsion kya ho jayega, kam. Therefore bonds, they come closer. Second thing, as bond pair goes away, so lone pair comes closer. So lone pair repel more, bond pair repel less. So bond angle decreases. But in this case, you know, nitrogen is more electronegative than hydrogen. So bond pair are closer to nitrogen, so उनके बीच की जो distance है, distance between bond pairs कम हो जाएगी. So bond pair repulsion बढ़ जाएगी. If bond pair come closer to nitrogen, so this lone pair is not attracted towards nitrogen. जितना attract होता है उतना attract नहीं होगा. तो आप इसको अगर ऐसे बनाओ, इन NF3 लोन पेयर इज क्लोजर टू नाइट्रोजन, इन NH3 लोन पेयर इज अवे फ्रॉम नाइट्रोजन. नाउ सी, लोन पेयर इज अवे, बॉन्ड पेयर आर close, so bond pair repel more. No doubt lone pair bond pair repulsion is always greater than bond pair, but as bond pair are very close, they can repel more, therefore they slightly expand. So bond angle in NH3 is greater than NF3. On the same basis, you can explain H2O and F2O. H2 has two bond pairs, two lone pairs, two bond pairs, two lone pairs. So bond angle of H2O is greater than F2O. Now what about this? In all the cases, all have four bond pairs and no lone pair. As these have no lone pairs, then this effect is null and void, and there is no difference created by the electronegativity of surrounding atom. Isliye effect is of central atom having lone pair. If central atom has no lone pair, only bond pairs, then there is no effect electronegativity of the surrounding atom. They have same bond angle, that is 109 degree 28 minute. When the surrounding atoms are same but central atoms are different having lone pair, again draw same rule can be used, that is Wesper theory. See, again nitrogen is more electronegative, bond pair are closer to nitrogen, lone pair is slightly away. In this case, you know, phosphorus is less electronegative, so bond pairs are away from phosphorus and therefore bond pair position is less. That's why ammonia has higher bond angle than pH3. Same we can apply for H2O and H2S. So which angle is more? Obviously H2O has higher bond angle than H2S. When central and substituent both atoms are same but central atom has different number of lone pairs. For example, we have NH4 positive, NH3 and NH2 negative. Now in first case, nitrogen has four bond pairs, ammonia has one lone pair, three bond pairs, NH2 negative has two bond pairs and two lone pairs. If you don't know how to calculate bond pairs and lone pairs, please watch my previous video, how to calculate bond pair and lone pair. Now see, it has all the four bond pairs. When there is one lone pair, there is a repulsion for bond pairs, they come closer. And if there are two lone pairs, there are lone pair repulsions as well as lone pair bond pair. Therefore bond angle decreases more than this. So in this way, as number of lone pairs increases on the central atom, bond angle decreases. Let us discuss one more case in which central and substituent atoms are same but they have different lone pairs. For example, in the first case, there are two bond pairs and no lone pair. In second case, there is one odd electron, NO2 negative, there is one complete lone pair. So there is no repulsion at all. Angle is 180. But when there is a one electron, one unpaired electron, that is also called lone electron, there is a repulsion for the bond pairs, but here it is lone pair. So lone pair repel more than lone electron. That's why bond angle order is like this, right? No lone pair, lone electron, lone pair. So lone electron repel less than lone pair. That's why angle is least in NO2 negative. Here there is no lone pair, so angle is maximum.